Focus groups and customer surveys are traditional ways businesses learn about their customers. Why are these avenues no longer useful in the digital age?
The human interactions, the surveys, there's bias there, of course. There's a lot of bias when it comes to what people are saying. So a survey, under certain pressures, like a consumer will feel like, I gotta say something nice. It's like talking to a doctor. So are we really getting what they're saying as true? Is that the true north? Or is the data really telling us they don't do that? I think when you're mixing qualitative and quantitative, you're getting a fuller picture of the customer, and that's what we work on.
How are you using AI to help sales and marketing teams get a better understanding of their customers?
Using AI to be able to really change the way marketing and sales is working together and be able to start surfacing what is really happening in the processes we created around our customers, understand their pathways, understand the happy journeys we place them on, but also the unhappy journeys. AI also comes in the prediction part. So it's not just prediction of, oh, this must have happened in the past and now it's gonna happen in the future. We're changing services and products continuously. We're adding new brands, we're adding new ways of interactions. That means we can't just look at the past and be like, this is what's gonna happen. As we're adding more and more services, the complexity of a journey changes. So we need to be able to use machine learning to keep up the real-time customer journey and to really understand who the customer is, to create wonderful brands, but also have a salesperson to say, I'm gonna target you, and that's who you'll get the right message from me.
How does your solution compare to the way marketing and sales is done today?
So today there's two silos. You find that the teams between marketing and sales are not talking to each other. Marketing is not using sales tools, and then sales don't use marketing tools. So can we be the bridge? We don't want them to change their patterns of research or how they sell. What we want to do is become the unifying tool where they can share multiple data sets and work on seamless integration of data to create that whole journey. And then for someone who's marketing to really be strategic and create wonderful brands, and then the sales team can go after and start pinpointing who they want to target. We're finding pain points in that collaboration, but also that we're not only an analytics company, we're an orchestration company. So we're a full cycle where you can audit the customer, but then you could tactically go after them, and then full circle come back and figure out what changed. Because your customer is going to change as you start interacting in a different way with them. It has to be full circle.
What opportunities do you see for the company in being here in Silicon Valley?
I think it's the diverse perspective that the VCs see, and they have a global perspective of what's happening. They know the trends in technology. They understand where capital is flowing. They can keep you ahead of what might be happening around a corner, right? Which customer should I go after next? Do you have a connection I can make? I love when sales is happening. So for me, I prefer when sales hits my bank account because I know it's validated. So the validation for me is understanding that I'm kind of focusing my efforts the right way, or at least getting that perspective in such a competitive landscape. And they can give me that perspective.